morning students, welcome to 10th standard algebra lesson number 6 statistics module 6 frequency polygon. Let's recall what we studied in the previous module. The graphical representation of the data, that is histogram. Next graphical representation is frequency polygon. A frequency polygon is a graphical form of representation of data. It is usually drawn with the help of a histogram but can be drawn without it as well. Children, in previous module, you have already studied how to draw the histogram. Now, we will be learning the methods of drawing the frequency polygon. First one, with the help of histogram. First point, draw a histogram from the given information. Second point, take one additional rectangle of height 0 preceding the first rectangle and the rectangle of height 0 succeeding the last rectangle. Then mark their midpoints. Third point, mark the midpoint of the upper side of each rectangle of the histogram. Fourth point, join all midpoints in order by line segments. And then last point, the closed figure so obtained is the frequency polygon. This is I am showing here the frequency polygon with the help of histogram. The second method is without the help of a histogram. The first point, prepare the table with the four columns including class mark and coordinate of points. Second point, decide the coordinates of each point with respect to each class. Third point, show the class mark on x-axis and frequency on y-axis. Fourth point, plot the points on a graph paper. And fifth point, join the successive points by a straight line and get a frequency polygon. Practice set 6.5, question number 2. Show the following data by a frequency polygon. We have to draw the frequency polygon. In this question, the class and frequency are given. Then solution. First, we have to prepare a table showing the coordinates of points. And we have to make the two additional classes. One is preceding class and another one is succeeding class. But in this table, the class preceding the first class would be negative 202.0. And the midpoint would be negative 100. But the electricity bill cannot be negative. Therefore, for convenience, the midpoint of the preceding rectangle is taken as 0. In this table, here the first class is 0 to 200, 200 to 400, 400 to 600, 600 to 800, 800 to 1000, and this is the here the succeeding class 1000 to 1200. And then second one is the class mark. See how to find the class mark? Upper limit plus lower limit divided by 2. 0 plus 200 divided by 2 is 100. Next one 300, 500, 700, 900 and 1100. And frequency is already given in your question. First one is 240, 300 and next is 450, 350, 160 and here the succeeding class frequency is 0. The coordinates of the points, first coordinate is the x coordinate is class mark and y coordinate is the frequency. That is 100 and 240 and next is 300 and 300. And next is 500 and 450 Next is 700 and 350 and 900, 160 and last one is 1100. First, to draw the horizontal line xx dash and vertical line yy dash, and the intersections of the x-axis and y-axis is origin. The coordinates of origin is 0, 0, and intersection point you have to mark it here 0. And show the class mark on x-axis and the frequencies on y-axis. Here in this question, the class mark is the electricity bill. Therefore, show the electricity bill on x-axis and frequencies on the number of families on y-axis. And here the class mark is starting from 100. Therefore, on x-axis, you have to start with 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900, 1000 and 1100. And show the frequencies on y-axis, that is convenience frequency you have to take. Here I am taking the starting from 100, 200, 300, 400, 500 and 600. Each point you have to keep the equal distances. And your first coordinate is 100 and 240. The first to mark the x coordinate is 100 and y coordinate is 240. Mark the point, this point is 100 and 240. And second coordinate is 300 and 300. The mark the point 300 and 300 is here. And third coordinate is 500 and 450. And fourth quadrant is fourth coordinate is 700 and 350. And next point is 900 and 160. And last coordinate is 1100. After that, here it is, join all the points by the straight line. Then you get a closed figure. And the last, here is a starting point 100 to 240. This point join with the 0. Then you will get a closed figure. It is the frequency polygon. And scale also right here. Scale x-axis 1 centimeter is equal to rupees 100. And y-axis 1 centimeter is equal to 100 families. Here, question number 1. Observe the following frequency polygon and write the answers of the questions below it. Here, this is the frequency polygon, and here the coordinates are marked on the figure. First one is 35 to 20 and 45 and 40, 55 and 50 and 65 and 60, 75 and 35, 85 and 15. And the first coordinate is the class mark, and second coordinate is the frequency. That means frequency is the number of students, and first one is the marks of the students. Your first question is, which class has the maximum number of students? Maximum number of the students is here. 65 and 60 is the coordinates. The 60 is the maximum number of students. Therefore, that class is 60 to 70. Second one, write the classes having zero frequency. Zero frequency means lies on x-axis. Therefore, the classes are the zero frequency are 20 to 30 and this one is 90 to 100. What is the class mark of the class having the frequency 50 students? Therefore, in this coordinates, the 50 students is, this is the coordinates, 55 and 50. What is the class mark? Class mark is 55. And fourth question, write the lower and upper class limit of the class whose class mark is 85. Here the class mark, the coordinate is 85 and 15. Class mark is 85. Therefore, the lower and upper class limit of the class is 80 to 90 is the class. 80 is the lower limit. 90 is the upper limit. How many students are in the class 80 to 90? This is the class 80 to 90. How many students are here? 15 students are here. Here are the answers. Which class has the maximum number of students? The class 60 to 70 has the maximum number of students. And write the class having zero frequency. The classes answer is the classes 20 to 30 and 90 to 100 have the frequency zero. Third question, what is the class mark of the class having frequency of 50 students? Answer, the class mark of the class having 50 students is 55. Fourth question, write the lower and upper class limit of the class whose class mark is 85. The answer, the lower and upper class limit of the class having the class mark 85 are 80 and 90 respectively. How many, question number 5, how many students are in the class 80 to 90? There are 15 students in the class 80 to 90. Question number 3, the following table shows the classifications of percentage of marks of students and the number of students. Draw a frequency polygon from the table. We have to draw the frequency polygon. In this table, the class and frequency are given. First solution, we have to prepare a table showing the coordinates of the points. And in this table, we have to make two additional classes. There is one preceding class and one succeeding class. One preceding class is 20 to 30 and next is our class 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, 60 to 70, 70 to 80, 80 to 90, 90 to 100, and succeeding class is 100 to 110. And next write the class mark. First class mark is 25, upper limit plus lower limit divided by 2. Next one is 35, 45, 55, 65, 75, 85, 95, and 105. And frequency, this column is already given in your question, but first term is the frequency is 0, that is the preceding class frequency is 0 and succeeding class frequency is also, you have to take it as 0. Next one, 7, 33, 45, 65, 47, 18 and 5. And coordinates of the points, first coordinate is the class mark is the x coordinate. And y coordinate is frequency, therefore 25 0 and 35 7, 45 and 33 and 55 45, 65 65, 75 47, 85 18, 95 5, 105 and 0. Here draw the horizontal line is x x dash and vertical line is y y dash and intersections of the two axes to mark it here 0 and show the class mark on x axis and frequency on y axis. Class mark means result in percentage and the number of students are is the frequency on y axis. And here the class mark is 25, 35, 45, 55, 65, 75, 85, 95 and 105. That points mark on x-axis. Here 25, 35, 45, these points are marked on here x-axis. And on y-axis, the frequency, convenient frequency, I am starting from here, 0 to 5. 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35 and like that. And your first coordinates of the point is 25 and 0. That means x coordinate is 25, y coordinate is 0. x coordinate is here, is x coordinate is 25 and y coordinate is 0. And second one 35 and 7. Here it is 35 and this point is 7. And next one is 45 and 33 and x coordinate is 45 and y coordinate is 33. And next one x coordinate is 55 and 45. X coordinate is 55 and y coordinate is 45. And next is 65 and 65. X and y coordinate is 65 and 65. Next one is 75 and 47. And x coordinate is 85 and 18. Next coordinate is 95 and 5. And last one is 105 and 0. First, all points you have to mark on the figure and then join all these points by the straight line. Then you will get the closed figure. This closed figure is the frequency polygon. And on x-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 10%. Here the class interval is 10, that is why this one is 10%. On y-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 5 students. Problem set 6, question number 11. The time required for students to do a science experiment and the number of students is shown in the following grouped frequency distribution table. Show the information by a histogram and also by a frequency polygon. In this table, here the classes and frequency are given. In this question, we have to draw the histogram and frequency polygon. Solution: first, we have to prepare the table and showing the coordinates of the points. And we have to make the two additional classes are the preceding class and another one is the succeeding class. The first one is 18 to 20, 20 to 22, 22 to 24, 24 to 26, 26 to 28, 28 to 30, 30 to 32 and 32 to 34. And second one, the class mark is 18 plus 20 upon 2 is 19, 21, 23, 25, 27, 29, 31 and 33. And frequency is first one 18 to 20 is the frequency is 0. And 20 to 22 the frequency is already given in your question. That is 8, second one is 16, 22, 18, 14, 12 and last one you have to take as 0. Therefore the coordinates of the points, first coordinate is 19, 0, second one is 21 and 8 and third one is 23 and 16, next one is 25 and 22, next one is 27 and 18 and next is 29 and 14 and next is 31 and 12 and last is 33 and 0. Here draw the horizontal line x dash and vertical line y dash and intersection of the two axes, here to mark it as 0. And here we want, first we have to draw the histogram. Therefore show the class on x axis and frequency on y axis. Therefore your first class is 20 to 22. 18 to 20 is your preceding class and next class is a succeeding class. Therefore your histogram you have to draw with a 20 to 22. Therefore mark the points is here 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28, 30, 32 and 34. Your first histogram is class is 20 to 22 and 22 to 24 is the histogram, the classes. And frequency you have to mark in y axis. The convenient number is starting from 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, like that. First class is your histogram 20 to 22. Is 20 to 22 is the frequency is 8, and 22 to 24 the frequency is 16, and 24 to 26 the frequency is 22, and 26 to 28 the frequency is 18, and 28 to 30 the frequency is 14, and 30 to 32 the frequency is 12. And next, here we want to market the coordinates of the points. First coordinate is 19 and 0. That is, the class mark is 19 and frequency is 0. Therefore, in the x-axis, the 19, 0 means this is the midpoint of 18 and 20. That is 19, and frequency 0 means the points lies on x-axis. And next coordinate is 21 and 8. 21 means there is the midpoint of the histogram. This histogram midpoint is 21. And the next one is the midpoint is 23. And here the midpoint is 25. And next is the midpoint is 27. Next midpoint is 29. And here the midpoint is 31. And last one, the midpoint, you have to mark it on x-axis. That is 33, and 0 is the frequency. This is the histogram and frequency. And frequency is the closed figure. And you have to mark it, the scale also here. On x-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 2 minutes. And on y-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 2 students. This is your histogram and frequency polygon. And question 4 practice. Draw a frequency polygon for the following grouped frequency distribution table. In this table also, the class and frequency are given. This class is the discontinuous class. You have to make the continuous class, then you have to draw the frequency polygon. Thank you, children.